Hi, it's Cindy Novotny with your Monday Mentor Moment. And this is number two in my series to finish out the year talking about trust. So today I want to talk about trust as a sales professional. You know, why did you get into sales anyway? Now you might be listening to me saying why I'm not in sales. Well, everyone, just so you know, is in sales. So if you own a business and you've got salespeople working for you, you're in sales. If you work for a company and you're in research and development, you're in sales. You have to sell and pitch your idea. If you're a creative talent listening to me and you're all the creative and somebody else goes out and sells it, you're still in sales. You have to pitch your idea. You know, there's a lot of reasons people get into sales in the beginning. They get into it for a couple reasons. One is to make a lot of money. And there's a lot of people that fail because they don't know how hard it really is. The other thing is they get into it for recognition. Some people love the awards and the recognition that you are the top salesperson this quarter. So when I think about trust in selling, it all starts with really honestly having a desire to present your customer with the right solution. You know, whatever you're selling or creating, if somebody's wanting to buy it, but it's actually not the right fit, then that does not give you any trust. If they're calling you back saying this didn't work and you don't handle it immediately, there's no trust. So look at it this way. Why did you get into business in the first place? Why did you get into sales? It's okay, there's two different ways I look at it. One is you wanted to make a lot of money, you wanted to have freedom, you wanted to make a difference in people's lives, right? The other is you wanted recognition. You wanted to be able to have people recognize you and accept you as somebody who is doing great things. Whatever reason, it doesn't really matter as long as you're trustworthy. So when salespeople are not trustworthy, they experience feedback from the customer, such as, well, you didn't tell me that. Why didn't I know that? You didn't say that in your proposal. That's not the price you originally quoted me. Right off the bat, I can share with you, not that trustworthy. See, everything should be transparent. Everything should be upfront, and trust comes in many ways. One is, I say I'll call you back at 5 o'clock. I call you at 5, not at 6, not at 7, not at 4, at 5. I say I'll get the proposal to you by Monday. I have it to you by Monday. I say that this is going to be the price parameter I'm working within. I stick within it. Trust is so simple if you actually want to make a difference. But to be good in sales, you need to have the hard work, and you need to have the trust that you can do the job, and that the operational team that's behind you will support you in everything you do. So have a great week selling, a great week creating, a great week building your business. But remember, we're all in sales and we all have to be trustworthy. See you next time.